to the Ranger Recap, the only Power Rangers podcast that asks the question, if you're watching this video on YouTube, why didn't you get to Rangerstop in Orlando? Make some noise! Yeah! Glad you guys could make it. Glad you blew off, well, whatever else is going on at the con that's way cooler than us.
Not really much, but yeah. Who cares?
Well, yeah. Not yet.
Rangerstop!
Yes. I am the Riffmaster General, the Toku guy, numeral uno. I am Easy Rider. That's my co-host, The Shades. That'll be Matty Jay over there. And hello. Matty, I believe you have something to show off.
Yeah, let me just bring this down so you can see the logo of our fair little show here. There we go.
DLC is awesome.
This thumbnail here designed by one of our fans, Zeltrax Millennium. Big shout out to Zeltrax.
Oh, awesome, yes. Dude. Also, it's called self-promotion.
Yes.
It also helps.
Yes.
But yeah, I am wearing what is half of what I consider it to be an El Cheapo Magi Blue.
Or Mystic Force Blue, for those of you who know.
Blue, of course.
Viva Rule 63!
Here's the story about behind this. You're looking about the most oddball, but most awesome find you could ever get at a thrift store.
Really?
Thrift store, $5 for this.
That's great.
Yeah, you're looking at the whole thing that I got. I got the gloves, the shirt, and the cape.
Capes are cool. Chip was right, Mystic Force. I want my cape back.
That helps as well.
It might mean much to you, but it means something to me.
That does. But also, we should mention we had a little chance to be in the dealer's room a little early. I think, should I show off?
Dude, of course.
I scored first blood among our kind.
Relevant!
Yes.
He did.
Matty drew first blood in the dealer's room before any of us.
Yeah. Matching mother phone, ladies and gentlemen. Lose 40 bucks and one of the, do we know the name?
They said I forget the name of the booth, but I know what you're talking about. You guys will see them. They have a whole bunch of several boxes of loose stuff, including collectibles and full toys.
We are going to lose a lot of money.
Yeah,
we will be broke, just like many of you will be
by the end of this weekend.
My paycheck's going right out the door. College, fuck college tuition. Rangerstop is what I'm spending.
I'm gonna be the broken son. All right.
That's everyone here.
I was gonna
let these guys talk for a bit, but this man just brought up the North American legendary Megaforce Morpher, Super Megaforce Morpher. I've been wanting to show off a little bit before we get to our main event.
Can I say something first, Matty?
Sure.
Yeah, I know Mighty Morphin Season 3 is your favorite season of Mighty Morphin Season 3. You look like when Bulk dressed up as a Power Ranger to impress those girls.
Ha ha! Oh god, I remember that.
Damn! Then he became a cop. He became a cop afterwards, so he should stop. That's
Bulk true. Then he became a guy living in a garage.
That's lost.
Alright.
You might want to talk here, because,
how about them Knicks?
How about that little sports team?
I'm from New York, man.
Now, you're alive with this, look what happens. All right. Check this out.
I'm going to have to use Easy's microphone for a little second here, because actually, I'm going to let you do the honors.
Oh, boy. This should be good.
This will be good.
Yeah, we have a name for this. It's called trolling.
Speaker is at the bottom right here.
Much more easy. All your dreams are about to come true.
We all know how it's supposed to sound, right? Listen to this.
Turn.
That's good. You hit it. French language version. They have like a big stack. At my Toys R Us, they had this big stack of Morphers. I picked one up, and it's got French writing. It's French. I'm in Ontario. It's Canada. We have to have both official languages, and it had both official languages on the thing. And it shows up like that. I turn to try it the first time, and I'm like,
that doesn't sound right.
Try it again. It's in French. Score.
And of course, in case you haven't figured it out yet, yes, this man has come all the way down from Canada to join us at Rangerstop this weekend.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, we got a fellow Canadian in the crowd.
Where?
I'm Canadian.
Oh!
Canada,
Canada.
Whereabouts?
New Brunswick, Canada.
New Brunswick, whereabouts?
Tampa.
No.
He's from Canada.
I'm born in Tampa. I'm Ontario and Quebec.
Ontario and Quebec? Which place? Because I'm from Canada, Quebec.
No. My grandparents were right over the border in Quebec. And then
he lived to both places.
I went back and forth between Toronto and that. They didn't know that.
He was very conflicted.
Yeah.
I can tell because I officially live in Ottawa. Well, I live in Canada, but I say it's Ottawa because
my entire life is
A little less complicated.
My entire life is saying Quebec and you stop. So
you came all the way down for this?
Yeah.
Why not?
Why not?
We did this last year. We were here last year. In fact, we've gotten a video from from our Ranger Recap panel last year.
On our YouTube, by the way.
Yep, RBT Entertainment on YouTube, man. So look them up.
Maddie, I just had an epiphany about this.
What?
French sounding morpher. And you know what France gets, right? Sentai. Bioman. Every Sentai that came after that was also called Bioman. Live Man was called Bioman 3. And they also got France 5, which if you haven't seen it, it's freaking awesome. So they're probably looking at this like, I don't know what French for what, Maddie, but huh? Que cosa? That's it. Close enough. That's
I can only do the Quebec flat version. It's like
Spanish.
C'est quoi?
I have the language.
All right. Can we get the main event, gentlemen?
This is where I usually take over.
Yeah.
Because I like to introduce these episodes. Now, we're going to have a treat for you guys, because we're going to have something that most of you probably forgot even existed.
Oh, the mystery, the original fact.
That's too easy. Went even more obscure than that.
We found an anomaly in Power Rangers history, something that should not exist, but does.
Scorpion Rain!
How about
we wish we had Scorpion.
How about a series of episodes of Power Rangers without any Power Rangers in it?
Non-canon, mind you.
It's been marked non-canon, but it is officially produced. These are the prologue minisodes that they aired before the debut of Power Rangers Zeo.
Oh, I heard about that.
Two words. It's coming. Phrasing boom.
Now, for those of you who are new here, what we're going to do is we're going to have the episode up here on the screen for you guys to check out. And while you're doing that, you're going to hear us basically giving our little commentary on the whole thing.
If you've ever heard of Mystery Science Theater 3000, you're welcome.
Yeah, you know what to expect.
Basically, you came here early to watch a bunch of grown-up geeks watch an old show and make crappy jokes about it. Feel good about yourself?
I would say that.
Don't worry, we'll make it fun. Don't worry.
Jokes. I mean, we wouldn't be here in the first place. Press badges, mind you.
Don't mind my self-esteem, Maddie. My low self-esteem. I've had it all my life.
All right, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to count it down. We're going to go 3, 2, 1, play, and then we're going to start the video. And I want you guys to come along with us.
Please.
We're going to have as much fun with this as we can. So.
Oh, yeah.
So, are you guys ready?
Yes!
That's what I want to hear. Let's get this started. Power Rangers Zeo, the prologue minisodes. In 3, 2, 1, play! Last time on Power Rangers, shit hit the fan.
I told Alpha not
to. By the way, we're not totally BG.
Yeah, just a word more.
Dang it, I told Alpha not to put an egg in the microwave.
He never learns.
He needs to empty that coffee pot.
Ever since he kidnapped those kids at Christmas. Oh, never mind. He's even off.
All the way again. The boss is no friend to him. Now back to music. The boys are back in town. The boys are back in town.
Saturn, a different kind of car company.
All of this space station music.
Prepare to fire the mega cannon.
They better not be spying on the girls.
Raising.
You'll be hearing that a lot too, folks. Sorry. Put the men's room at the top of the tower. What was I thinking? I wonder if I could see my house from here.
You forgot to turn the lights on again. Now I'll be epic.
Thank you for coming on such short notice, Dr. Jewel.
Felicity Smoke? Wow, she gets around.
Crazy!
The Rangers get fighting to the end!
Yeah, Great Lord Zed. How many times did he do his butt kick?
Too many.
Too many.
By the way, Lord Zed, I still hope you have that RV. I have a feeling we may be using it.
And a master of cheese.
Master of evil?
Okay, yeah, stop phrasing.
Oh, what happened? What'd you
do? No! Stop saying it's coming. Bad video. Just... quiet. Quiet.
Day?
Moving right along. Moving right along.
We here at RVT do not condone the act of physical violence. We do, however, find it hilarious.
Moving right along.
It feels good to be finally rid of those
motherfucking cards. I really need to take that.
Yours, I'm the evil overlord around here.
I'll make you get anything.
She'll get half in the divorce.
The days upon the earth below. Oh, ours for the taking.
How would you miss it?
What?
It's your ex!
Oh crap, this legend voice Andrew wanna go on a double date.
Damn it!
I thought I
oh, I saw the mention that she had for her own movie for a Popish. This ain't your father.
The ultimate evil power.
Oh, man.
The ultimate evil power in the universe.
Sorry, not now.
What is this happening with Donald Trump? Honestly.
I know, right?
Serious. Reed, you get a headache for everything.
You get a headache for Nama now.
You get a headache for...
never mind. Just
go. No, let's not go.
That's not good.
Also, these mini-sodes are 95% telescope.
Party's over.
Telescope.
Time to call it a day.
So what about my porn stash?
We've got to
get
out of
here!
He has
that super mega vision,
right?
He's
still taking
it.
Yeah, my queen. Sorry, back in. You blew everything else up.
Back in line. Not going anywhere.
Also, why are they so close to you, Dory?
They'll be here any minute!
Put out some hors d'oeuvres!
It's like a wilderness party! How
about you? But I'm not sticking around
to
find out!
I'm going back to my dumpster!
Meanwhile, at the mysterious observatory
of Doom.
My pleasure, Dr. Kendall. It's not every day that
I have made the ultimate iPhone.
We've all been hearing rumors in the scientific community concerning an unusual disturbance in the Earth's atmosphere.
It's like a million PowerPoint fans cried out in terror and were suddenly silenced. It's called
the only reasonable explanation.
Dun, dun, dun!
Maybe not.
Maybe it's she's born with it.
Wait a minute, this is a giant kaleidoscope! What the hell is all that scientific funding be going to?
Epic, sorry, epic last song last year.
Doctor, what is the memory
field?
You don't want to know.
Marcellus Wallace's soul.
Ah.
That makes sense.
Bernie Sanders, he's a scientist.
These are photographs taken this afternoon from our space
test. Oh, God, not that picture. Oh, please tell me that's not public.
Not yet, but it will be if you do not cooperate.
Not a meteor.
Well, that Kamen Rider Mach gets around for photographs, doesn't it?
That's not a meteor. That's a space station. Too big a space station.
Oh, the world's going to end, and... oh, the world's coming to an end. How about Starbucks?
I'm a Dunkin' Donuts guy myself.
Oh my God, they're being invaded by giant clocks!
Clock people finally figured something out.
Which is good news, since our local heroes, the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, have not been seen or heard from in quite some time.
Those bunch of lazy bastards will never be able to take a world at this rate.
Whereabouts of the multicolored keepers of the peace. This reporter has received several anonymous phone calls from sources that
believe the power reporter
may have returned to their faraway, distant planet.
We will,
of course, keep you informed and up-to-date on any further developments. That's our report for the scene. Remember, if you've got a hot news tip,
you
call me at 555-972. This is Wolfgang Blizzard reporting.
Oh, he's talking to Commissioner
Blizzard.
No, he's calling Batman. He's going direct.
Custodian Joseph Saunders. In your own words, tell us what you saw.
I had Jello today.
I don't want to cram it.
I see.
shiny, fast.
Lovely. We've got another cook on our hands. Let's get out of here, boys.
Bring someone this way.
They're coming to take me away. Ha ha! Ooh, he threw the ball!
Who can we contact to substantiate this report, Mr. Saunders?
So how long until this is a YouTube video with auto-tune and memes of aliens?
Those two are aliens!
Get them! We're live at Angel Grove University, Dr. Kinder and Dr. Jewell, the two scientists who first saw
the alien
space.
They're turning the juice bar into an FDA.
Ladies and gentlemen, the
now the real stars of the show.
Well, what then? We can't answer that.
Sneak away, boys. Sneak away.
In this case, sleep too.
We do.
So, it's a secret alien spaceship.
And right now, Fox News immediately blames it on Obama.
You think of what I am? Hang on, I am. Can you imagine what Rangerstop would do if we
aliens extraterrestrial in the station?
You would yell at us. No, we did metals.
Scorpion. I heard that, Curtis.
We are going to prove something that slave driver Lieutenant Stone once and for all.
Slave driver.
Let's go.
I want to be.
Hello, boys.
We're doing it.
And that face.
Well, boys,
yeah.
Prove something to
that freeze. That freaking face. That for raising.
An alien spaceship right in the middle of nowhere.
Hawkmire, you have a choice. You can stand watch out here.
Boy, it's a good thing. The juice bar relocated to this wide open space.
Yeah, seriously, that was fast.
With this.
Ten stone can teleport. Right,
that's impressive.
Yeah, just keep a keen eye out for those space. Totally not stolen from the grease.
Stone thinks he can keep
calling it now, they're gonna flare from the
sleep for the rest of the video.
All it's missing is the black wings are on their eyes, they put the binoculars down.
Our keen sense of danger will let us know if anything unusual.
Where's Tommy?
That's a very good question,
yo!
Actually.
That is a very good question.
Their keen sense? I don't know, guys. You think these guys should go into the detective agency or something? I don't see it.
Long shot, though.
Oh, now they're going to start spooning. Isn't that cute?
Excellent development.
Just spread the word on YouTube, for God's sakes.
If this is any indication,
I have a right to speak for some.
Keep in mind, folks, God made this.
Wonderful. And after we conquered them, we'll strip the planet of its resources and complete our machine empire.
Okay, the way she said that, phrasing.
Phrasing.
This show should not use the word strip.
Yeah. Let me tell you something I can.
So, you heard it here first.
Not saying it was aliens, but it was aliens.
Alien forces headed toward Earth.
I am now moving my pants.
Emergency information.
Down.
This is Wolfgang Blizzard reporting.
Not to be confused with the guy on CNN.
Actually, he wishes he was Wolf Blitzer.
Seriously. On the count of three, we casually stand.
A spaceship landed on Earth and only these two saw it.
Two.
See why this is non-canonical?
Bad cops, bad cops. Bad cops, bad cops.
Run away, run away.
Wow.
Bulky, I think we missed the three-legged race.
I think we lost it by a mile. We missed it by a mile.
Looks back, it's still
they
right there.
They walked all the way to Stonehenge!
Damn.
Wow.
No one knows who they were or what they were doing.
I guess you're right.
A commercial?
Do you know what those are?
Oh no, interpreter dancer!
Oh, those are the worst.
No! Dad! No!
Cut it out! We gotta find what's gonna
happen. Hey, you guys know where Daisy is?
Just stop!
I'm looking for a Burger King! Sling away, boys!
Sling away.
He's eating his own hand!
Spell the hand.
Spell it!
You startled us.
Oh! It's you. We fight the aliens now. I think they'd be safer.
Next time I'll call them.
Why weren't you acting so? Why should you take them out of bucking in stalls in the horse control?
It's only a
seems to be a job.
I see.
I believe.
You do?
Pull my finger.
Hey,
boy.
All those shots at that close, and they still miss.
Stormtroopers.
Sweet Mondo set the cogs for stormtroopers.
Sorry, Ernie, that's classified information.
Yep. We rubbed soot on our faces. Obviously, we were attacked.
We fell on the ground 3 times trying to run. I'm looking poor, Ernie.
Is this crap? I gotta reconsider these scores.
I might be able to look for another job at this rate. These guys are driving me up a damn wall.
Me, I'm doing metal doors. Maybe I'll let that other guy named Ernie go and throw you
here. Ernie, this is no joke.
I told him it was a bad idea, but I guess he won't listen.
Yeah, what?
Haven't you been watching TV?
Yeah, sure, guys. You're also going to go to a planet and save the Rangers. Then you're going to become monkeys. Then you're going to become invisible. And then you're going to save the world and count down to destruction. Whatever.
Yeah, let's keep telling yourself that.
And now, the man who wishes he was president of the United States.
Officially declaring a state of emergency.
Did we tell you?
Did we?
So Richard Nixon finally took office, it seems.
For a third time? Oh, God, it's the Watchman.
A hostile alien ship heading towards the Earth.
Yeah. Hey, aliens are going to destroy us!
Ernie, 100 bucks, now.
All right, the aliens are going to destroy us. It's fun! And they cleared God.
Why is it so hard for you to believe that we were right?
Because it's you!
Aliens must be strong in the face of this crisis. Finally, I would like to issue a plea to the Power Rangers, wherever you are.
Get it off your asses and help!
The time we needed you.
Now, have you seen my wallet?
The safety of the people of Earth may depend on it.
They're at a little place called Rangerstop.
Yeah. Am I right?
Are we right?
The Rangers can't help you, old man. They're too busy making army kick off.
Indeed, my king, and with very good reason. Everything on Earth is almost at an end.
Even the mighty Wolf.
So this is Mr. Stewart's second life. He's not on Earth yet.
That's a lot.
Did you have to remind us of that?
Yes.
Also, she's a fan of the Kardashians.
There's that many spaceships landing on Earth, and they didn't conquer it in that brief amount of time?
Nope.
Stack them over there with the
others. No wonder they got their butts kicked.
I guess what we can do now.
Emergency supplies. Here's where we'll hoard all the legacy items past my
own eyes, Eddie. It doesn't look good. And the only ones that can save us seem to have vanished into thin
air. Say, Lieutenant Stone, how'd you like to run this place today?
I don't know. Probably not.
And then never appear in Power Rangers again. Where is Lieutenant Stone? We need him back.
Seriously.
He's got to get the band back.
Let Lieutenant Stone be a mentor.
Please.
You should know that Mojo.
I hope Axelrod got 2 paychecks this season.
Seriously. And Barbara Goodson, for that matter.
True.
We're filming. What? Set face palm.
There it is.
We're meaning that.
That's our event name. Are you kidding me?
Ah,
what is it, my dear? Just tell me what it is.
It was a meme before it was a meme.
Ah.
Look who's already here.
Look, Seth, come over. We'll have tapas. We'll watch Glitz World. We'll have fun. We'll bring out the board games. And if the idea of swapping wives is interesting to you, what? Nothing.
Put that gun on it.
Actually, the way the King Mondo's looking, he should lay off the tapas.
And now for a taste of things to come.
I think some of these people are here today. I don't know, guys.
What? I don't know.
They're running around somewhere. Maybe they're getting out awesome autographs or something.
Yeah. Or at least they will be.
Maybe.
I kind of wish Lieutenant Stone was here. I'd love to get his autograph.
Oh, hell yeah.
Jonathan Zacher.
Zacher. Boom, this man.
There it is.
It's not a Power Rangers podcast if we don't boo Zacher and praise Chip Lynn.
Yes. So there you have it, folks. The Zeo Prologue. What do you guys think?
That's good. Thanks. By the way, we have some nice people coming in.
I hope you're spotting our jokes and not that.
Either way, you're welcome.
By the way.
That's 20 minutes of my life I'll never get back.
Hey, better to go in here than outside where it's not comfortable.
You're right.
Especially for those wearing the ninja
Ranger
cosplay.
I got some ninja rangers.
Go ninja, go ninja, go.
That is awesome.
I made another funny.
I want a close up. Mike, get a close up of these guys right there.
Stand up.
Stand up.
Look at that.
Yes.
That is awesome.
Beautiful.
That is awesome.
Well, after that torture, we'd like to open it up to some Q&A, but, you know, mind the rules, mind your manners, mind your P's and R's. See what I did there? Keep it short and sweet to the point.
Any questions, raise your hand. I'll be glad to walk up to you guys.
Yeah, any questions you have about our opinions or about, you know, anything range-related, by all means, ask away. One thing we do is emails and comments on our podcast, so that's what this is going to be right here, is comments.
And after the show, if you want to know how to contact us, well, we'll tell you.
I'm going to go with the lady in the Pink Power Ranger show.
Yes,
over here.
Ladies.
All right.
Here we go.
Big Pink.
All right, here you go. Come on in.
I came in late. Who are y'all?
We are the Ranger Recap. We're a Power Rangers podcast. We take a look at the most basically what we just did now. We do that for the newest episode of Power Rangers every week. And if they're at the off season or a special occasion like this, we rip a classic episode. And then we get everyone's opinions on everything.
We
like
analyze it. We also
talk about newest type of 7 things. Time Fire, aka Quantum Ranger.
Dude.
Loving that.
We recognize.
Yep. Actually, true fact, earlier today, yours truly over here got himself an exclusive interview with Dan Southworth, which we'll be posting up on our channel after the con, so be on the lookout for that.
We will be taking care of that for sure.
Yeah. Look for RVT Entertainment on YouTube. You'll find us.
Yep. If you're looking for actual names, my name's Matty Jay. The man in the red shirt is the Shades. And over there in the white shirt, that's Easy Rider.
Where are my morphers at?
Yeah.
Who's got morphers on?
Okay, Ninja Rangers.
Hey, you guys get a pass.
You guys get a pass.
If you're more...
What'd you do?
I hit the wrong button.
Matty Kara strikes again.
Yes.
Yeah.
But if you're more, you're cool.
Yeah. Also, one of our mottos, RV's Entertainment.
Yes. I believe you are next, sir.
Okay, I acknowledge this is a stupid question, but seriously, what the heck does a robot need with a fan? We see Queen Machine always having the fan. What the hell does she use?
You know, that is a good question.
My guess is she runs on the same function as a Sony PS3. That thing heats up fast.
That's a cooling unit.
Yeah.
You go right in.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Well, we got to run next here. I think I know who this is.
Oh, wait a minute.
I think I know who this is. Yeah.
Reveal your... Who is this mysterious
gentleman? Dio, is that you?
We're finally going to find out who
is it. Is it John Cena?
Finally.
Is it Global Fuerte?
It's me, Austin!
Oh, son of a bitch!
It's me, Austin! It was me all along.
Dio Bond.
Dio Bond, ladies. Oh, you guys.
That is awesome.
Oh, you wouldn't see it coming.
That's an awesome costume.
That is good. That is good.
And this is handmade by my dad over there in the back. Give him a call.
Yeah.
Good work, sir. You're good.
You're so awesome. That is awesome.
Especially standing next to Maddie. Sorry, Maddie. Sorry.
I'm right in the field, man.
Hey, sorry, Maddie. You gotta make Roman. I mean, Dio Bot looks strong.
That is true.
Any other questions? Thank you,
Take your
Anybody
time,
else?
I'll go here.
All
right,
go ahead.
Right here.
How you doing? It's Solstar, by the way.
Yes. Hey.
Awesome.
Yes. Okay, what's a good way to explain that Sprocket and Gasper are one the same?
Ooh.
That is true. Yeah, for those who don't know, unlike the Power Rangers in the Japanese Sentai that this is based off, O-Ranger, Little Sprocket actually turns into Prince Gasket. It's not two separate people. So,
I not watched enough O-Ranger. I think I stopped at about episode 20. I know it's fully subbed, and I would love to see the rest of it, but I don't know. I think that was a brilliant move on Saban's part to make it two characters. Mm-hmm.
They look different enough that you honestly would not have known they were supposed to be the same person. So, it's tricky on that one, honestly. How do you explain that to somebody?
Dash to the time to have screen time together.
Yeah. Yeah, well, that was also in the Power Rangers adaptation, which, again, great job on them doing that. Honestly, the only thing you could do is just say that, you know, introduce them to the Sentai a little bit at a time. The only problem is O-Ranger is a very difficult series. That's definitely not a good starter series.
It has its ups and downs. Let's
not it does. That. Yeah. The first 10 episodes, dark.
Oh, yeah.
Dark.
Dark.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, and very dark.
But then Dancing Robot. Yeah. The show is so serious.
Serious for 10, the rest of it?
Not so much. Hey, robots need exercise too.
All right. Do you have all what you got?
Okay, recently I watched two episodes of Epic Rap Battle of History, which if you haven't watched, awesome. I have a question for you guys. If you were to pick two Rangers to be in an episode of Epic Rap Battle of History, hypothetically, who would it be and why?
Ooh, that's tough.
Not to put over a particular Green Ranger.
Oh, that's not even
good. But here's the thing. I would have the Quantum Ranger versus the original Green Ranger.
Ooh, I like that. I like that.
Ranger's better.
That's true, but here's the thing. They're both in their own league of badass. What would happen if they have a rap battle?
I could see that, but I would like reformed Rangers. What I'd do is, I like that I would have Tommy the Green Ranger versus Titanium Ranger. Who celebrates Titanium Ranger Day?
Yes.
Also, another in that same vein, Green Ranger versus Corone, the second pick.
Hey, you know what? Get some lady some love.
Technically, she's a ranger.
She is, and she was reformed, so that works.
Green Ranger versus the White Dino Thunder Ranger.
Hey, there's another one.
Yes!
I like that. I know, right?
It's their storylines are very similar, but
hell, even Tommy himself points it out in the story.
Yeah,
my Ranger's better.
Anyway, any other questions? Any questions? Anything
don't
you
be
want
shy.
To share?
We got
plenty of time to kill, folks.
Take your time. We're out.
We got an hour lunch. That's the whole beauty of this.
And it's not just about what you see here. We're talking about everything Power Rangers. So
yeah. If you guys want to share your thoughts or ask for our thoughts on anything Power Rangers related, by all means.
Or if you have a crazy idea for a fanfic or anything related to Tokyo.
We're not shy.
We've heard it all. Actually, one thing we can share is another thing we do on our show is the Sentai Tournament. For all of you Sentai fans out there, we have an ongoing tournament where you guys vote on which of two Sentai teams do you think is better based on weapons, power, skills, mechs, whatever. It's technically not supposed to be based on what you like better, but we all know how it's going to go. I mean, come on. It's a fan vote. Actually, believe it or not. Oh, actually, no. I don't think we've gotten a Kaku Ranger yet.
I think we have.
I'm not sure if Kaku Ranger is something. I know, yeah. I'll tell you this, though. G-Ranger, the Mighty Morphin counterpart, is out of the running. It actually lost.
Still, I can't get over that.
We're amazed.
Yeah.
We're amazed at the point. They're facing, of all things, Maji Ranger.
Magic!
Shut up, you weirdo. But. So if you guys want to follow that along, just join us on the Ranger Recap. We go live every Tuesday on our YouTube channel, and we have audience participation. We always talk with our chat when we're doing it live, and we read your emails and comments. And trust me, some of you guys give us some really good stuff to work with. But one thing we love about the emails and comments is that oftentimes you guys catch stuff that we miss. There have been times where we've read an email and they pointed out something that we didn't think about when we were looking.
Especially on the current episodes, we usually watch it once or twice before going live. And of course, we riff it live as it airs, riff track style, as a matter of fact. We don't actually air any audio from the episode itself.
Copyright and all that.
Copyright and all that, of course. And we've had multiple instances where we had to play back the episode just to find that one little bit that one fan saw.
Yeah. We've had plenty of times where we're like, we missed that? What?
What do you mean they're whistling the Kyoryuger theme?
Yeah.
Someone actually pointed that out.
We didn't realize it. We went back and double checked, and sure enough, one of the guys was whistling the Kyoryuger theme on an episode of Dino Charge. You have to really listen to it at the end of the episode. So it's little things like that. Let's go show our hands here. Who here has been watching Dino Charge?
Ooh, hello.
There he is.
You all.
How many of you have been enjoying Dino Charge?
That's the majority of
that's
them.
That's the majority of it. Awesome. Yeah. We honestly had our reservations about the last two seasons.
It's called Super Mega Force.
Super Mega Force really burned us. I mean, I'm sure some of you may disagree with this, but I won't say it was the worst series ever. I think Overdrive still holds that.
Overdrive is still worse.
But, yeah.
Mentioning Overdrive should be punishable by getting clubbed in the head.
Punishable by SBOD shots.
I agree. Agree.
Running, obscure running gag, but yes.
Yeah.
But Super Mega Force, and Mega Force as well, the whole series season, was the biggest disappointment, I feel, in Power Rangers history.
Yep.
Because it was the 20th anniversary. Even if you are not, if you've never seen the Sentai, you don't know about Gokaiger, the series that it's based on, it's an anniversary series, and they were hyping it up because of all the things that it was going to have. You know, being able to turn into other Rangers, storylines involving past Rangers, all of that was, they really bit hyped it up, and it just fell so flat.
Then in their mentor, we have a little something about this. It's like, whenever we ran into a problem with Super Mega Force on the Ranger recap, and when I review Toku and Power Rangers, it's what I do, we always have to ask, how the heck does that work? How does it work?
And if you know the, if you know our joke, follow along.
Oh, hold on.
Hit it.
I have to mute it to say
it. You ruined it.
Not yet.
You didn't see that.
We didn't ruin it.
Neuralizer.
We ended up ruining it.
No friend.
There we go. It's having to work with two screens, folks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Try it again.
They just get the new powers. They don't meet any of the past Rangers. They don't do anything like the past Rangers. But Rangers, you've unlocked the powers of blank. Insert Ranger team here. How the hell does that work?
There's a simple explanation for that.
Did it go say? Oh yes, the troll say joke. That's one of our running gags.
Every time something that doesn't make quite make sense from now on, the hashtag is right there.
There you go.
Also, we did not make this. Another podcast, Ranger Command, they brought
Ranger
it up.
Ranger Command Power Up.
We just ran with it.
They
get all the credit for
though, this version with the morphing, again, new exclusive. You guys have never seen this before. A lot of our fans have not seen this before. I actually modified it, where it actually morphs from Ghost Saiyan to Troll Saiyan. That was me. Yes, I loved it. I've been wanting to do that ever since I first saw the Troll Saiyan, him do this Troll Saiyan thing, so I was like, I had to. Too good. But yeah, but, come on, tell me you guys haven't watched episodes of Power Rangers and had that thought in your head.
All the time.
Tell me that hasn't happened.
Any more questions?
Anybody else?
Yeah, raise your hand. What you got?
You and me next, sir. Okay.
Have you guys ever seen Linkara's History of the Power Rangers?
I was waiting for that.
We love Linkara.
Can I tell you what he said about Samurai? Thank you.
Thank you.
Man.
Linkara has been pretty much spot on as far as what my opinions have been about certain series. But, funny story. Here's the thing. Easy here has been doing Toku reviews since like 2009, pretty much. And yet, when Linkara started doing History of Power Rangers, he still got called a ripoff.
Yeah, I did it first, and I still get ripoff. I would love to cross over with Linkara. He knows who I am.
Yeah,
he mentioned me on Twitter before.
Some of you guys have actually like pointed Easy out, like when Linkara did his Zooranger episode review.
Yeah, they mentioned my review of Zooranger, which is back up, by the way. With the Shout Factory subs, I re-edited it, and it looks great. And who's here for more Sentai on DVD in the States? Let me hear some noise.
Yeah.
Woo-hoo! Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Now, for those of you who don't even know what the hell we're talking about, yeah, Shout Factory has been releasing the Japanese Sentai stateside with subtitles for us to enjoy. They've already released Zooranger, which is what Mighty Morphin became. Or season one of Mighty Morphin, I should say.
Yeah.
And then they just recently put out Die Ranger, the second season of Mighty Morphin, where we have the Thunder Zords and the Tiger Zord. You're going to see that. And you will never look at Tommy the same way again when you see his Japanese counterpart in Die Ranger.
No.
The
White
Ranger.
You will never look at him the same way again. Because
Falcon turning overdrive, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Let's put it this way. I'll just sum it up like this. You thought Justin was the first child in a Power Rangers-esque series? Nope.
Nope.
You haven't met Nope. Nope. From the Die Ranger.
Nope. Nope. Stop saying nope.
Nope.
You
didn't
want to scale.
Yeah.
To answer your question, yes, we've seen History of Power Rangers. We love it. We can't wait to see what he does with Super Mega Force. You could tell in Samurai that he's going to
tear that a new one.
Yeah.
Oh.
You thought we were tough on it.
Oh, you have no idea.
Yeah, by the way, shout out for the shirt.
Yes.
What's she rocking
right
over here?
Right into that camera, right there. That is awesome. It's a Rita Repulsa shirt.
Oh!
It's
very nice.
It looks like it's Pokemon.
It is.
Oh.
Make my monster grow. Rita R used rare candy.
I like that.
It's super effective. I have
that's
to tell
awesome. This is why we come here. This is why we come to these cons.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. All right, what you got?
Well, I was just wondering if there will ever be a Power Rangers Dino Charge movie coming out.
There has been talks about what the reboot movie is going to be involving. Now, there was a rumor at one point, it was a rumor, it's been since been denied.
Debunked.
Yeah. That the reboot movie was going to actually involve the Dino Charge Rangers. But that would. But put it simply, if the source is collider.com, don't bother.
I subscribe to the theory of I'll wait till the movie comes out, or at least the first trailer.
Yeah. I don't even think there needs to be a movie per se. I think they should do what Disney did with Mystic Force.
Yeah.
Dark Wish. I love Dark Wish.
Yeah, they should make a special though, because there is
three-parter,
one.
Three-parter, you can divvy up into episodes, but make it an event, like a movie.
My hope is that for Supercharge, they pull off one special that the Sentai did. And make that work, because you can use the Sentai footage and make it work. And if you know what Sentai, if you've seen the Sentai I'm talking about, Kyoryuger, it was a three-way crossover event featuring the Japanese equivalents of Dino Charge, Dino Thunder, and Mighty Morphin. Think about that for a minute.
If that thought doesn't make you happy in your head place.
You're in the wrong.
You're in the wrong.
I'll do you one better, Shades. If you think that Jason and Connor, aka Austin and James, should come back to reprise their roles as the Reds in a team up like that on Dino Charge, give me a fives, yeah.
Fives, yeah! Oh,
I love you, people. I love you all.
Tell me that wouldn't be awesome. But yeah, they should do something like that as a TV movie, kind of similar to classical Red Rangers, only
only better.
One actually be good.
That's a troll say right there. Yeah. How's he not able to breathe? And you play that.
Yeah.
No, you want to replay it?
No.
Moment is past.
Get Trent back if you're gonna do that. No. We need to fight Dino Thunder Ranger.
Actually, sagas themselves need to come back. I did a video about this a long time ago. I do something Power Rangers related every November, which you'll see it this month once I get back. I did the top 10 Power Rangers sagas. And what I did was I took good stories from a bunch of seasons, excluding Mighty Morphin, which had too many. I couldn't pick just one. And some of these were really good. Some of them were four-parters, some of them were three-parters, but, you know, they tell good stories in the span of so many episodes. I think that's kind of the problem that recent Neil Saban shows have had. They're too condensed. They're all one episode.
Yeah.
Stories
that could easily fit into three episodes or even more are condensed down into one, and it feels so rushed.
And it keeps you in suspense. Look at what all the superhero shows are doing these days. Flash, Arrow, they always leave you on a cliffhanger to get you to come back. I think that's what something Dino Charge or Power Rangers in general needs to tinker with.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, Disney did that. Remember Mystic Force and Overdrive?
Yeah.
They kind of did that. They kind of let you hit it, especially when Nick had his baby blanket. He's like,
"Yeah,
no more secrets," and you're like, "What's he hiding?"
Yeah, seriously. Hell, even Joe was here to some extent.
A little bit.
I got my theory. Sequel bait, that will never happen.
Yeah.
I got a question over here from Zordon.
What?
What? Yeah?
What?
I called it. Hey, there you
Zordon.
Go.
Zordon?
Right over here.
I have a question. Do you guys think that we'll be seeing the Mutant Turtles at all? And if so, will it be the Michael Bay Turtles?
No.
Let's hope not.
Why would you even say
that? I don't think Saban has the CGI budget for those guys.
No. And the only other option would be to bring in the Nickelodeon Turtles that are out right now, and I just don't see how you can make that work.
Dude, you could. It wouldn't be that too hard to CGI the Dino Charge Rangers into the new Turtle show, which I've heard good things about.
That I can see working. You could do the reverse and have the Rangers show up in a Turtles episode, which would be a nice change, a nice difference from the old In Space days.
And you'd have a good crossover.
Yeah.
Yeah. As someone who has watched that movie, and I'm a fan of Johnny Knoxville and some of his movies, I'll leave it to the imagination of which ones they are, but
yeah.
I would find it jarring to hear Johnny Knoxville on a Saban production.
that would be a scary thought.
Yeah, because I know what Maddie's thinking. He loves a certain Johnny Knoxville show.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
But that would be a good crossover. Remember, how many 80s kids and 90s kids we got in here? Yeah. A lot. How awesome were crossovers?
Yeah. Those are always fun.
Yeah.
It's sad they don't do more of those.
Any other questions?
Yeah, please. Anything at all. Like I said, anything Ranger related, anything El Toku related.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, we got any Toku fans in here?
Yeah.
Oh, we know you guys.
Oh, come on. Yeah. You got
first that one row, guy in the back.
Half of the first row excluded, of course.
Yeah, we know you guys are. You come to our streams all the time.
Yeah. They're our regulars.
Seriously.
We're like a bar.
Oh, we got one. Addy. Oh, hold on. You'll have to
ask. One moment, folks.
I was just being told something else. Well, He actually was wondering if you could borrow the blaster for a couple of minutes for a photo shoot.
By all means,
dude,
man.
Take it.
Because that's easy. Bring it back to the man.
Autograph.
Whose hand was up?
Autograph by the man.
He's right there.
Oh, right there. There you go. And I'll catch you in the next.
Have fun.
All right, go ahead.
First of all, my name's Wesley. I came all this way from Lewiston, Idaho. And it was my first appearance here at Rangerstop. And I appreciate that you guys are saying, and so it's an honor to meet you guys. And I am very impressed with Dino Charge. The guys are dino amazing, the season's been dino amazing, and the girls are dino hot this year.
It's not a question, but I'm feeling the love.
But yeah, I'm gonna bless you.
And you're my back.
Yeah,
thank you.
Dude.
And you look.
Thank you.
Dude, before we go on, I gotta say, man, one, great to have you here. Two, you're making us blush, man. We appreciate the love.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely.
Nope. Stop. Stop. My face can only get so red.
Yeah. I'll get to him and I'll get to you. Go ahead.
Sorry. Yeah, on the subject of Toku news, what do you guys know? Do you know anything about the rumors about the next Sentai?
Jouger,
yeah.
I actually saw there was possible pictures out already.
Yes, I believe they are going for Animal Theme. I've not seen the pictures yet, but from what I know is I think they're going either the Sun Vulcan route or the Gowranger route, and it's an anniversary show. This could be huge.
Yeah, that would be interesting.
I wonder what the collectibles could be.
I'd be interested in how they do it the Sun Vulcan way. In modern times, obviously.
Yeah, but Matty, you gotta have collectibles.
Oh, yeah.
Toku without collectibles, and I just had a great idea for what the collectibles could be. I know what the collectibles could be. Animal crackers.
Okay. Oh, God.
And there's always one that's eating them. Those are power-ups, stupid! Now we can't summon that elephant mech.
Nice call.
This is obviously off-topic, but don't let him near to Homer Simpson.
Oh, no.
Okay. One more?
Peter Griffin.
Go ahead. Sorry.
I didn't have another question. I just wanted to mention, this is also my first Ranger stop, and I'm here from PA.
Very nice. Pennsylvania.
Very cool.
Very nice. Right. Don't be afraid to give a shout-out.
Yeah, please.
From Ninja Ranger here.
We actually all live here in Orlando, so thank God not having to fly on any airlines.
I live in Newport, Richie, dude. I know you're right there.
So I'm pretty sure you guys have already covered this in a previous podcast, but the dark rendition of MMPR.
Oh, Power/Rangers.
The one with the Dawson.
Yes.
Oh.
And I'll forgive that.
Forgive the Dawson.
We did cover that, actually, but we will be happy to share our thoughts on it again. Honestly, knowing what we know now, it was a cool idea, and I see what they were going for. Admittedly, I agree with a lot of critics on it. The biggest problem was is they didn't make it clear that it was supposed to be a satire of Grim and Gritty reboots. That was the intent, but they never made that clear. Now, looking back, it makes perfect sense. That said, when you look back at it and realize that it's a satire, it is hilarious what they did. Vulcan Skull being murderous gangster bully, you know, southern gangsters. Meth heads.
Yeah.
You can only imagine what Lieutenant Stone was.
Oh, I don't want to think about that. He'd be the super hard-nosed cop that basically...
2 days to retirement. Boom, boom!
He'd be the bad cop. You had Zach, you know, continuing the fight in that hip-hop keto thing. That was hilarious.
Oh, yeah.
And all of just all realizing the reality of it. I mean, and yeah. If this was basically a deconstruction, for those of you who know what that means, is basically taking an idea and going, what would actually happen if this was real? Anime fans know what a deconstruction is. Evangelion, Madoka Magica, those are deconstructions.
Oh, yeah.
That's what Power Slash Rangers felt like to me, was it was a deconstruction satire. Because, let's be fair, that's probably what would happen in the real world, in our world, if that was real. But I love the twist at the end.
Oh my god, that twist.
If you haven't seen it, I'm not going to spoil it, but if you've seen it, you know exactly what I'm talking about.
It's, I would qualify it as actually bad, per se. Because it's not.
It's worthy of Shyamalan.
It is. But.
Twist!
But I would say that it's not, it's obviously not intended to be a fan for the fans. It's just like, oh, it's the director's idea of reboots.
Yeah.
And as someone who has studied film in college and everything else, and who is obviously Power Ranger fan, duh.
No.
Really?
I never would have guessed.
No. I got it. I was as mad as people eventually got.
Okay. Yeah.
Per se. I get it. This is the best way to put it. But that and the way they did Hip Hop Hokkaido. So Zach, Hokkaido.
Close
enough. This is irrelevant. Then.
You want me to take over, Manny?
Sure.
Like your thoughts? Okay, bottom line. Could this reboot work? Yes and no. I'm always drawn between reboots like this. On the yes side, unlike other reboots, they stuck to the source material. They got the characters right. I'm sure that, as you folks know, there have been some other reboots out there that bear very little, if any, resemblance to the source material. I won't say her name, but you're all thinking it. A certain band leader. Starts with a J. Yeah, I think we all know how that movie bombed.
Yeah. Let's put it this way.
A lot of producers take the source material and butcher it until it looks nothing like it. A good example is a movie I just reviewed, The Giver.
Yeah.
Steve Lang wanted to keep it to the source material. He wanted to keep it just like the anime/manga. But Brian Usna, the producer, wanted to make a kiddie film. Yeah, an alien superhero ripping monsters apart. That would go great for the kids. The point is, they stuck to the source material in this fake reboot. But no, it's too dark and gritty. I mean, I know that's what they're going for. It's too dark and gritty. It is a parody. Toku and Power Rangers in general walk that fine line of being too dark and too kiddy.
Yeah.
There's that fine line they walk, because sometimes it can get a little ridiculous. Also, thank you.
Yes. Thank you, sir.
I think they went a little too far. Again, I know they were going for that, but even for a parody, my God, this is... Yeah.
Power/Rangers.
I don't want to use. I don't want to mention a certain director, but this is something he would do.
Yeah.
So, yes and no, this could work. It has its ups and downs. It has its pros and cons.
You should be more classy like Michael Bay. Michael Bay.
And you ruined it.
Yeah.
All right.
On that note, we're going to wrap things up here. But before we go, we want to at least give you guys, if you guys enjoyed what we did here tonight and want to see more, again, search us out on YouTube, RVT Entertainment, and you'll find us, or search for the Ranger Recap. We're not hard to find.
We had a site, but it died.
Yeah, we have a site. We're in the middle of a transition. We are working on a new site, so don't worry. We will be back up soon. But we have our YouTube, and each of us all have our own YouTubes, especially me and Easy here. I've got, you know, Look the Shades Up and Toku Time. You can find us. We have all sorts of reviews, podcasts, live streams for you guys to check out.
You can also find it on my personal website, tokutai.me. It's just Toku Time with a period in the middle of the I them. And the recap is there too. All the recaps are there, and my videos. So.
And the audio, and we all usually keep our live streams up on YouTube permanently. And we have our audio versions available for up to 4 weeks,
depending on how the seasons go and everything else.
Podomatic.rvt's Ranger Recap. Podomatic.com/Ranger. Yeah.
You get the idea. But with all that, you'll know where to find us.
Oh, yeah.
We're not having
cards. Go up and get a card afterwards.
There you go. We got some bit cards. If you guys want to check out Easy Site, that'll lead you to pretty much everything else.
And the recap.
Yeah.
It'll lead you right to the recap.
But definitely check us out. We love doing this stuff. We also do a show called Toku Risk Live for you Sentai and Toku fans, where we rip the latest episodes of Toku and some classics as well. And you can, for those who don't know, this is all from the Japanese series Kamen Rider Double. I'm a huge Double fan.
Double!
Adapt Go Busters!
Yeah.
Make it happen, Saban. Follow us.
But definitely check us out. We enjoy having you guys, and thank you guys so much for being here. You guys made this an awesome panel. Now, VIPs, you guys can go out that way. Everyone else has to go through this door here. I want to thank you guys for tuning in. Easy, send us off.
I'm Easy Rider, reminding you that the fan sub will never die. We are your Ranger Recappers. We will see you on the air, on the internet, and as always,
don't forget the dino charge.
And may the power protect you. We love you.
Rock on!
Have a great day.